Have you ever observed a ship or a boat moving through the water? Why am I asking? Of course you did. You should have noticed that it generates a trail behind it called the wake. Then, if you raised your sight and saw an airplane, you noticed the same wake behind them as they pass through the air. Usually, it appears when the aircraft is moving through clouds or when there's enough moisture in the air to leave behind the trails. This wake is generated by wingtip vortices, while an aircraft that encounters another aircraft's tip vortices can experience wake turbulence. Today, we discuss wake turbulence and why a line of air can cause a catastrophe. Explaining what is aircraft wake turbulence. To explain wake turbulence, we need to understand how the magic of flying works. The wingtip vortices, or tip vortices, are generated due to the difference in pressure between the upper and lower surface of the wing. The upper surface of a wing is at a lower pressure, and the lower surface is at a higher pressure. The same pressure difference enables a wing to create lift. The hardest part is done. Let's move on. As the wing's lower surface is at a higher pressure than the atmosphere, the air tends to flow outwards towards the tip of a wing. Meanwhile, the wing's upper surface is at a lower pressure, and the air tends to flow inwards. At the tip of the wing, a swirling motion is triggered by mixing the high and low pressure air, which produces vortexes. When the wing is viewed from behind, the right wing produces an anti-clockwise vortex, while the left wing produces a clockwise vortex. If you know how water vortexes or tornadoes work, you know that getting in any vortex is dangerous. The first tip vortexes appear when the aircraft rotates for the liftoff during the takeoff phase of the flight. This continues until it comes in for the landing and then touches down on the runway. The strength of the wingtip vortex depends on many factors, including gross weight, airspeed, configuration, and attitude. Vortexes are at their fullest when an aircraft is at the point of takeoff and landing. That's why pilots, particularly those flying behind a much larger aircraft than theirs, must be cautious during these phases of the flight, or a catastrophe might happen. An accident caused by aircraft wake turbulence. An encounter with wake vortexes can cause the aircraft to enter a roll. The total effect of a trailing vortex is felt when the aircraft enters it laterally. The intensity of this rolling depends on the strength of the vortexes, but once the aircraft gets into a vortex, the situation gets unpredictable. On the 12th of November 2001, an Airbus A300-600 operated by American Airlines was on a scheduled international passenger flight from New York JFK to Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic. The crew lost control of their aircraft just 1.5 minutes after takeoff during the second of two minor wake turbulence encounters. The following destruction of the aircraft by ground impact forces and a post-crash fire led to all 260 occupants and five others on the ground being killed. How ATC operates to minimize the risk during takeoff and landing. Due to the dangers of wake vortexes, every aircraft must follow separation rules. It's air traffic control's responsibility to know the required distances and control the aircraft so that the given minimum separations are maintained all the time, since the aircraft crew is not always aware of the aircraft type ahead of them. Previously, the aircraft categories were based on the maximum takeoff weight. However, recently, research has proven that in addition to weight, other aircraft characteristics such as speed and wingspan also affect the strength of the wake generated and the following aircraft's reaction to the wake. Today, aircrafts are reassigned to one of six new RECAT categories, A through F, derived from redefining the transition weight between the old categories, adding a super category, and splitting each medium and heavy category into two new ones. You can see the resulting categorization on the screen. In cruise, the separation is fixed for all types, a horizontal distance of 5 nm between leader and follower, and a vertical separation of 1,000 feet. Hopefully this video has helped you acknowledge the jewelry work of pilots and aircraft control. What would you like to learn next? Let us know in the comment section below. Remember to like, share, and subscribe so you can enjoy the excellent content we send your way.